Okay, my name is Bing Lee, and I'm from class P13. So this is my ISSE project. So for introduction, I'm tasked to review the current environment and come up with a security plan which should cover endpoint security, access controls, computer misuse and cybersecurity and data protection. In the next following slides, I'm going to talk about the security plan. So I have 5 laws: access with intent to commit or facilitate commission of offense, unauthorized modification of computer materials, unauthorized disclosure of access code, consent required, and protection of personal data. So if there are no law for the access with intent to commit or facilitate commission of offense, those that use computer will be able to commit crimes. So recommendations are to block programs and websites that are not trusted, employ those people with no crimes regarding cyber acts. So justification, prevent staff from committing crimes, and also by employing those with no crime regarding cyber acts, they tend not to commit any cyber crimes. So next law, if there are no such law, users that are not authorized can change any information of the computer. So it's recommended that they implement locks to the computer to stop people from getting access to the PC, and also implement security features to computers. Why? Because this will prevent people from getting access to the PC and end up modifying the data in the PC, and this will prevent people from modifying the data on the computer too. So unauthorized users with no authority can disclose password, access code, or any other means of getting information to any system or data in another PC. So recommendations: limit logical access based on the job requirement, and make sure that only authorized users can access data stored in the computer. Why? Because limiting logical access to any staff based on job requirement ensure that unauthorized staff will not disclose any password, access code, or to other people. And by making sure that only authorized user can access data stored in computer, unauthorized user will not be able to leak the password or access code. So next, consent required. The company can announce customers and employees' personal information without their permission. It's recommended that company should ask permission from employee or customers before disclosing their personal information. So why? Because by asking permission from individual, company will not get into conflict with the individual and can therefore disclose their personal information. So next, protection of personal data. Lastly, if there are no law, personal data for individuals are at risk of getting disclosed. So it's recommended that they give only trustworthy staff access to customer data and harden the network by installing firewall as the antivirus to servers and computers. So justification: trustworthy staff will most likely abide to the rule of the company by not disclosing customer data, and which will prevent hackers from getting access to information within the company. So this is my physical access for Singapore. So there's 10 management rooms, 1 data center at the corner, and customer service near the entrance, and the rest are other departments. So it's the same for the Malaysia and Indonesia, except that there are no 10 management rooms. So physical access. Physical security controls that can be implemented are security cameras, biometric lock and lock for main entrance. So security camera can record down whatever is happening in the office. Biometric, employees can use their thumbprint to access the entrance, which prevents strangers from entering, as their thumbprints are not registered in the machine. So the lock for main entrance will prevent robbers from entering when no one is around, as it is hard for robber to break through locks. So logical access. All systems and apps will be classified by the information security officer depending on their knowledge with respect to data confidentiality, system availability, and data integrity. Once classified, the apps list authentication and authorization demands will be controlled by the system owner and documented depending to the risk and sensitivity. All systems and apps would most likely have documented policies and strategy for approving and abort access. There are no unknown guest accounts or any system that are classified as sensitive. The management that are answerable for an information system should give out a special account to every people authorized to get their hands on the information resource. Accounts on most systems will have a non-shared special password too. So these are my five endpoint security, which I'm going to show the weaknesses, how to improve, how to deal with the weakness. So click right here. Okay. So for the first one, ensures configure Windows Smart Screen is set to enable. Why? Because Windows Smart Screen helps keep PC safer by warning users before running unrecognized programs downloaded from the internet, which can cause some virus in it. So what you're gonna do is go to edit. Yeah. Edit group policy. So firstly, go to edit group policy. Then while waiting for it, okay, go to computer configuration administrative and Windows component file explorer right here. And lastly, configure Windows Smart Screen. Then you just need to enable it and apply. Okay, the first one is done. Okay, next one. And so ensure that turn off data execution prevention for Explorer is set to disable. Why? Because data execution prevention is an important security feature is supported by Explorer. They have to limit the impact of certain types of malware. So go here and execution turn off data and set to disable. Okay, next one. Ensure that turn off heap termination of on corruption is set to disable. This will allow an application to function after its session has become corrupt, increases the risk posture to the system. So go to turn off heap and disable it. Okay, apply. Okay, next one. Ensure turn off shell protocol protected mode is set to disable. Because limiting the opening of files and folders to a limited set reduces the attack surface of the system. So all you have to do is go here, turn off shell and set to disable. Okay, for the next one is a bit different. This one. Ensure prevent a computer from joining a home group is set to enable. Because while resources on a domain join computer cannot be shared with a home group, information from domain join computer can be leaked to other computer in home. Okay, so go here, back, home group, home, yeah, right here, yeah, here, and set to enable. Then apply. Okay, now I have to run the thing again. Okay, as you can see, 5 passes now. Pass. Okay, so in conclusion, I managed to come up with 3 computer misuse acts and 2 data protection acts with the detailed information written. So after that, I came up with 2 office plans for 3 countries, one for Singapore and the other for both Malaysia and Indonesia. Then I identified physical security controls that can be implemented in the office plans and identified how logical access should be restricted for the end device. So that concludes my proposal. I hope Mr. Seo will be able to take on, will look in detail into my proposal. Thank you.